In the last class, we were seeing what was partnership. When two or more persons come together and they agree to share profit and losses by doing a lawful business, we call it by the name partnership. Now, in this session, we are going to see what are the types of partners on the basis of certain duties or certain responsibilities or certain activities they are doing in partnership. They can be classified into different types. And in this session, we are trying to see the types of partners as well as types of partnerships. Persons who are in partnership can be of different kind. At the same time, agreements can be also of different types. Now, in this session, we will be seeing types of partnership and types of partners. So, we start the session. The types of partners. Commonly, there are six types of partners based on the role they are playing, the responsibilities they are taking. Types of partners can be of six types: active partner, sleeping partner, secret partner, nominal partner, partner by STFL, and partner by holding out. So there can be six type of partners. Now we will see in detail what is this all about. Active partner, as the name says, active partner is that type of partner where he contributes capital, he brings in capital, he invests money to start business, he participates in management of the firm. That is the very reason why this name is given to this kind of partner, because he is actively participating in the management of the firm. He shares profit and losses, he or she shares profit and losses, and that partner has unlimited liability. He has to pay even from his pocket. If a loss arises, he can have the share of profit according to the agreement and takes part in carrying out the business and on others' behalf, as we have said. So basically speaking, the major point which is talking what is active partner is this one. He participates in the management of the firm. So that is basically what is being said here. So now, actively participates in the management of the firm, he contributes capital, shares profit and losses, and have unlimited liability. So such kind of partners are called as active partners. That is one category of partners. Next type of partner is just one point different from this one. He is called as sleeping partner, or we also call him dormant partner. Because he also contributes capital, but what is differentiating him from an active partner is that he does not participate in the management of the firm. He also shares profit and losses, and unlimited liability is the rest is similar to active partner. The only point which is differentiating sleeping partner from active partner is that he doesn't take part in the management. He pays the money and he is allowing the active partner to work into. He will not look into the business. He does not participate in the management of the firms. That is why it's called as sleeping partner or dormant partner. The next type of partner is secret partner. Secret partner The name itself says why he is called so. He also contributes into the capital, but he also participates in the firm. He shares profit and losses, unlimited liability, rest of the things is similar to active partner. The point of difference or point of differentiating is his association is not known to the public. Public will not be having any idea that this person is a partner of the firm, or it will be kept as a secret. Rest of the thing, contributing capital, participating in management, sharing profit and loss, unlimited liability, everything will be there similar to an active partner. But what makes him secret partner is that his association will not be known to the general public. So he is called a secret partner. Now coming on to nominal partner. Nominal partner. Nominal partner. Nominal always denotes name. So here actually if you are asking he is a partner, we cannot say he is a partner, but he allows his name to be used by the firm as a partner. Maybe a celebrity, maybe a film star, or why? Hearing that so and so person is a partner, people will have more people will feel more reliable. So such kind of things, for such kind of things, many of the persons are considered as nominal partner because his name is being used by the firm as a partner, allows firm to use his name. He does not participate in management, he does not share profit and losses, he have unlimited liability because he is also representing the firm. He have unlimited liability, he does not contribute to capital. So his name is being used because of his goodwill. The goodwill he is having, the fame he is having is used as a partner. That is why he is included as a partner, and there he is considered as a nominal partner, and that is another categorization. Now next one is partner by estoppel. Partner by estoppel. If a person by his acts and actions he is giving an impression to third party, that means outsiders, that he is a partner of the firm. That means if three of us are there and one more of our friend, three of us are partners and one more of our friend who is a common friend of all the three of us, he will be there every time with us. Even when we are in firm, even when we are outside, everywhere he will be there. So seeing him at the firm, seeing him always together with us, people misunderstand him as a partner. People misunderstand him as one of the partners, or he is also there in the partnership. By his actions, by his way of doing things, third parties are feeling that he is a partner of firm. Impression is created by third party, but he doesn't know that he is considered as a partner. That means he is unknowingly representing himself as a partner. He is unknowingly representing him as a partner. That is what is being said. Gives impression that he is a partner of firm through his behavior. He is unknowingly doing that. He doesn't know that people are considering him as a partner, but because of his actions, because of his way of doing things, people are getting a feeling that he is a partner of the firm. And he doesn't share profit and losses, he does not participate in management, he does not contribute capital, but he has unlimited liability because people are having a feeling that he is a partner and believing that if he is doing something which cost them, automatically he will also be considered liable. He has unlimited liability. But he is not knowingly doing this, he is unknowingly representing him. That is called a partner by estoppel. Partner by estoppel, unknowingly allowing him to be represented as a partner, or unknowingly allowing others to have a feeling that he is a partner of the firm. He is partner by estoppel. Next one is partner by holding out. Almost similar, third parties are having a feeling that he is a partner. But what differentiates partner by holding out from partner by estoppel is that partner by holding out knowingly allows him to be represented as a partner, allows himself to be represented as a partner, but is not a partner. That means he is knowingly allowing third parties, or he is making giving a feeling to third party that he is a partner by he is knowingly doing that. He want others to feel him as a partner. So estoppel was unknowingly representing. Here it is knowingly representing him as a partner, but he is not a partner. That is partner by holding out. Again, does not participate in management, does not share profit and losses, does not contribute capital, but have unlimited liability. Same reason, people are misunderstanding him as a partner, and if any cost is spent, automatically he become liable. He have unlimited liability towards third parties. So these are the six types of partners. See, different roles, different responsibilities are there for them. So that are the different types of partners. Those are the different types of partners. Now we are going to see different types of partnership, how partnership contracts can be. Now types of partnership can be classified on two bases. Types of partnership can be classified on two bases. It can be classified on the basis, or contract of partnership can be classified on the basis of duration, the time period. Second one is on the basis of liability, that means repayment. So partnership can be classified on the basis of duration and liability. On the basis of duration, we can classify partnership as partnership at will and partnership, a particular partnership. Partnership at will and particular partnership on the basis of duration, time period. On the basis of liability, repayment, we can classify it as limited partnership and general partnership. Limited partnership and general partnership. So this is the classification of partnership. Now what is partnership at will and particular partnership? That is classification on the basis of duration. Partnership at will exists at the will of partners. That means it will be formed on the like-mindedness, or they are feeling that they want to do something on the will, on their likes, on their mutual agreement, it is coming into being, and it will continue as long as they want it to be continued. It will be going forward till any of the partners want to stop it. According to their will, according to their like, they will go on. So that is why it is called as partnership at will. It is formed on the basis of will of partners, and it will continue as long as they want it to continue. They will close it as and when they feel not to continue. And second one is particular partnership. Particular partnership, the name itself says, formed to accomplish a particular purpose. It is that type of partnership is formed to do a particular activity or particular function or particular project, say build a house. build a house or build a flat or something like that. So it is for building that particular, the completing that particular project they are doing it. And this partnership will come to an end once the project is completed. It is automatically dissolved once that project is completed, completing a flat, completing building an apartment, their partnership comes to an end. So that is partnership at will and particular partnership, the classification on the basis of duration. And on the basis of liability, it is general partnership and limited partnership. General partnership is talking about liability of partners which is unlimited and joined, because all the partners have equal rights in management of the firm. So general partnership, liability of partners are unlimited and joined, whereas limited partnership, one of the partner will be having unlimited liability and rest will be having limited liability. But management in the firm will be done by the person who is having unlimited liability. Those who are having limited liability will not have power of a management in the firm. So that is type of partnership on the basis of liability. So we have seen types of partners and types of partnership.